Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia tutorial. So, today I will show you how I did this picture here, one of my last pictures. And yeah, the inspiration of this picture came from here, from this great guy, from this great artist here, from David Moreno. Moreno, I don't know how to spell it, but I think that's not so important. Important is what he does. It's crazy. You see, he makes things like this, and this like bird cage. I tried as well. So something like that. And yeah, and this was almost more complicated than the staircase because of this. And you have to try to stay here and almost the same height. And make this door or something else here, and yeah, and here on this I used just the cloner, and yeah, the people asked me if on the original you see I made it with X particles, and people asked me to show this without X particles because not everyone has X particles, and yeah, of course we can do this without X particles, and as I said, we can do it with a cloner, but here. I want to try, this is done with X particles, but here on the staircase I want to try it with hair, and yeah, should work as well, and yeah, with the cloner it works for definitely, but with hair I don't know, I didn't try it with hair, but it works for sure, why not, and yeah. And without X particles, we can make it. It is this here on the wall. This pattern is done with X particles too, with the network modifier. But this we can do very easy. So then without X particles. And yeah, that would say let's start. And you know, no, let's start. I want to show you that this works first. I mean, and yeah, this was what I did, and he does more. This I like. This looks a little creepy if you ask me. And yeah, here another staircase, and another one, and now comes the thing. First, I thought this is a 3D program where he did it, and then no, this crazy guy does everything by hand. Look at this. This is more than impressive, I think. This is really crazy. This is nice. I really love it. That's great. Okay. So now we can start. Good, for the staircase, let's make the staircase first and maybe let's see how we have time. Then we can make this birdhouse as well. Good, yeah, for the staircase, I make two splines in front view. Let's bring in the grid array so I have a little more control. And enable snapping with work plane snapping and grid point snap. And this one should go from here, let's say. Okay. And now I want to make a new spline here. So I have to do it in the spline bank, create new spline. Otherwise, it would make just one spline. But I want two splines, and I'll show you later why. You will see it why. And here I make another one from here to, but not until here because you see the bridge icon. It would make again just one spline. Now I go to here, and now I have two splines. This is spline one. Let's see. Doesn't matter. We bring them together. So. I just don't bring them together now because I want to offset them a little bit. So I want to have this one here. And take this spline here and offset it a little bit. So let's see. 200 here. Let's see how that looks. Could be a little. Too much, so I'll go back a little bit. So something like that. And now I can go with this one point up to this point here. This is, now it's okay. And so I disable the snapping, select my two splines and say current state to object. Not current state to object, I see connect objects and delete. So you can do this with a right click here too. So you have here connect objects and delete. And this is the stair spline. Okay. Now I wanna clone some cubes on it. So let's make a cube and put it so. I do it just I know, but you of course will make it better, and I hope you will show me later on when you did it. So let's see here, 50 5 200, okay, and put this thing in a cloner. So I select my cube, MoGraph, alt click on cloner, so the cloner becomes parent to the cube. And I want to clone on objects, and the object of course is the stair spline, not effector. You can hear stair spline. Yep. Okay, that's not really what we want, so don't align the clone, and we have our staircase. But now we see, okay, this is maybe it goes over it, this is not what I want. But we can make, of course, the cubes a little smaller. Something like that. And here a little or so. Best would be that they don't overlap here, because I want to have hair down here everywhere, and I don't want to go over this, because then we have hair here too, and this would then to be too dense if you have hair over here. So let's try, we don't overlap here, so something like that should be okay. And I want two steps here on the end, so in the same height. And this I can achieve normally when I say don't loop. Loop, nope. Yay. See, now we have here exactly two things. This is totally what I want. And maybe I want some more steps. But wait a minute, when I do more steps, then we get. Because in my picture, you see it, what I mean. I want to do it. You see here, everywhere where it's darker, they overlap a little bit. And this is a nice effect here, of course, yeah. But I can achieve this effect in another thing, in another way too. So okay, a little bit overlapping. Let's see, go from count to step, or stay by count, this doesn't matter. Something like that. Okay, this should be okay. Maybe make it a little. Yeah, as I said, you can do it however you want. So okay, now this is okay. And now the end is neat. I make my cube here editable. C on the keyboard, chung, editable. Go out of the cloner. Now I have here my cube, and as I said, I want on the just here on the edge down, and on the other side the same. I want then hairs down. So I need here to some points and to select, and on these points I want the hair then. The same would work. It would work the same with the polygon object, and it would work as the same for the X particles. We need these points. So what I do is go to my cube and go to the edge mode. UB for And I don't need UP here. Just 9 for the live selection. I select this and this edge here. And I wanna cut this edge in some segments. MF for the edge cut tool. And here we have subdivisions. And then let's try 20 and say apply. Then I go here. And 20 looks not bad. Now I have here lots of points. On the other side I should have the same too, yeah. Is 20 enough? Yeah, 20 should be enough. You can, if you want it more dense, so you make more. But I think we can work with this. And now, point mode, live selection. I select these points and on the other side the same. So shift select here, whoops, and make a selection tag. Good. Activate the cloner again. And now I make the cloner editable. So I want just one object. You can make the cloner editable with this edit optimize script, or you put it in a connect object, the cloner, and then hit C on the connect object. But be sure that render instances is off. That's important. Otherwise you would have just one step. Good, so I just used the edit optimize script here. You will find the link for the script in the description of the video. And whoop, so I have one thing. And the nice thing we made before, the selection of the points of one clone. Now, if we click on this selection, you see we have the points everywhere selected. So we don't have the work to select again every points. So let's save this. To get a desktop, and stairs. Why is this big? This shift caps lock here doesn't matter. Good. Okay, let's continue. So sorry, I had to make a little break. Okay, you want to, but someone in front of my window, I have a big construction site in front of my window, and they thought they have to work with the jackhammer now. But this is now half an hour, no, not half an hour, some minutes. it's felt like half an hour. And and now we can start. So where have we been? Okay, we have our selections here. What I want now is, I want just one of these blanks here and make a way here. So nothing easier than that. So I go in my, with UW, you can select the all polygons, they are, how is it called? Select UV, yeah, select connected, they are all the polygons, they are connected. So with UW, as you see, now I have this one, and I right click and say split is UP, is the UP, and you see I have another one here. Now I have just one of these planks, so E, and I don't see any, you see here is the axis. So I go to my magic center tool and have my axis in the middle. As I said, the plugins you will find in the description. And I just bring this out here, rotate it 90 degrees. Here I don't need a cloner or something else. I do it by eye, so E. Because we don't really see the people look at the hair and everything, and not if here is everything correct aligned. And now I just control drag it to the side, control drag and hold my shift key a little bit, so I have over time, okay, 30, control shift click, control shift click, 30, control shift click, control shift click, make control shift click, Okay. Here that we just we don't see this, but we can a little distribute different things. Does really not have to be. And it looks maybe better if it's not so perfect, because this wouldn't be perfect. I think, at least when I do it. Yes, here I remember one, not one, more people asked me this, if I can record webcam to my tutorials. I do not really understand the sense, because when you have now here in the corners or something, my face is I don't know if it's if this has any sense for me. It's I don't like it either when I have this, but mostly when people make tutorials and have their webcam recorded with them, mostly the webcam is over the values they type in or something else, so that it's that's more. But tell me if you want to make webcam record the webcam too. Then I have to clean up my bureau. Blah, 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 blah. Just tell me this. Okay. The same we do here. We make some to here to the wall, or make maybe some straight and then go to the wall. Yeah, let's make some. Okay, so I take this one here from the corner here. Now, come on. Let's make the live selection. So now I have this. Select this one, UW, and UP for split. Then I should have you on. So, and E, you see that the axis is here. So magic center, point. Drag this somewhere like here. Control, drag it. You see, there's really no need to make here another clone or something else. So R for rotation and I control rotate. So if I hold control, it makes it with the rotate tool again a copy. E, so bring this to somewhere I like it, so somewhere like here. Okay. Well, let's make it from here so I see how far I have to go. And we will make here some too, so let's go to somewhere like here. It's far away, but doesn't matter. We could do this. I could copy these times. Let's try this. This would be a try something. I make here this cloner and make some copies. Control C, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V. So we started at 14 and we have to 21. Select all them, go to the coordinates, and I say in the this is the X axis, let's see if you're right. I put in here num times 35 centimeter or 30 centimeter 30. Okay, this was the wrong direction. I thought it should be set num times 30. Okay, it's here, but it doesn't matter. But I want 35 num times 35. Doing okay. And I drag this to here. See, so I don't have to make this with the steps. Looks not bad for me. I hope for you too. So but I always said we want more. We want it until here, and then make some more. 14 guys, 14 control Control C, Control V, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, make 5, so 14 was on the first, so, no, the 14 we don't need, so this was the reason, I think, this is the num times 35, whoops, okay, this is enough, I don't need it here, I'll do the same data. Okay, but we should go with this guys a little far, because otherwise we would then go over this, so let's make here some more clones. First, I select these guys here, bring it to here, let's see, like here, then I select this one here, take the last selection, control, drag it to here, drag it here. Something like that. As I said, don't be too correct. That is not what we want. If you want to be correct, do it, but why should we? So nice and whoops, like it. Now we have nice blanks here, and we make some here on the top. Let's see. Take this one here, so life selection, bunk. UW, UP for splitting this guy, and we have this one here, bring it up here. That doesn't totally not matter what we do here, because we will bring everything together, so it's not really necessary to name it or something else. So we need the magic center tool. Let's rotate this guy here. 90 degrees. E for the move tool. Right here. Here I do not really need this. This trick with the num, whatever. No, nope, that's all I wanted. Okay, that should be built now. Let's make some here. Let's take this one again. This was 30. R, control, drag it. Rotate and drag it. So E. It's a little like playing Lego. Let's cheat a little bit, make this one a little broader. T for scale. Okay, now we have. Maybe this should be. So maybe that's okay for me. And we have a nice stairway here. Good. Save it. So and now we have to. I make everything. I make everything together. So, but put everything in a null object, alt g, and then I make a backup folder. Script is in the description, and control drag it inside here, so we have a copy. So, and here we select all the, yeah, you can select everything in a null when you click with the middle mouse button on the null. You see everything is selected, and with control click once of the null to deselect the null, then you have all everything. And connect objects and delete. Boing. The null I can delete. So, and now let's see what we have when we put our selection tag on. Here everything is great. It's exactly what I want. We need just on this side some. If we want, we can make it on the wall side too, but that wouldn't, it's not really not necessary because we won't see it. If we see it, we can do it later on, just add some points and that's it. Yeah, everything is nice. It's nice, nice, nice. We need here some points. That's it. Okay, let's make this. We go to edge selection and here with MF. And here we need some more, let's say 80 points. Apply, and let's see how many these are. Oh, that's that. I think this is too much. No, it is the same space almost like here. It's okay. And we select them. Shift select so that we don't lose our other selections. Okay. And with the selection tag selected, we override it. So set selection. Okay. And the same we do here. Go in the edge mode. Take this edge. MF for edge cut 80 is okay. Apply. And we should have the points here, which we have. Shift select these points. Be sure this is selected. Okay, set selection. Save your work, and we have our selection. We do not really need. Do we need? We do not really need the selections here. But that's okay with that. That is not. It's okay. We do not really need this selection in the inside here, but I'll let it be now. Oh, here we have some more. We need here somewhere. Here we need this one too. This one too. This is just okay. MF. Apply. Whoops. Selected. Override the selection tag and save your work. We do not need this here. Control select set selection. You can do this all later on when you say, no, but here I want some hair, here I want some hair, or clones or whatever, or more particles. Just make the selection tag, and you have the selection tag then in the wherever cloner hair X particles, and every time you change this, the thing will change here too. So it's a very nice setup here. Okay, I think we can be happy with this for now. And now, with the selection tag selected here. I go, so let's say these are the stairway selection tag selected, and I go to simulate hair, add hair, woof, we have hair, nice, we have hair, that's good. Let's go to the guides, and here I want the roots same like the guides are, so as guides. Okay. We have here 2,925 hair, and that's okay for me. So, yeah, we want the hair straight down. So, this should work. No, we don't need segments in between here. Yeah, if you want to curl the hair later on or something, this is a very nice look, by the way, when if you curl it a little bit. Well, I think it will be, but I didn't try it with hair now, but I tried the birdhouse with the cloner, and that worked great. And then, yeah, I tried it with hair, with the birdhouse, because with the cloner, I had splines there too, so and with the splines I rendered with the hair tag and. But maybe I show you this later. This is then just fun. So 300 height, we would say, so this should be okay. And we want them not polygon vertex. I want them. That's okay. Here, I want just one segment here. Not normals, I want direction. And the funny thing here is that there is just X, Y, and Z, but there is no minus Y or plus Y. I would need a minus Y, because when I go to Y and say here the editing, regrow, you see it goes in the Y direction, but I need the different direction, I need the other direction. I don't need plus Y, I need minus Y, and I can't do a minus Y here. And it doesn't help if you say, yeah, come on, Nico, just reverse the normals. Don't be so stupid. That doesn't help. I show you this. I go to here, select all my polygons. UR is reverse normals. UR, you see, the normals are reversed. Now I go to my hair, say regrow, and nothing happens. Update guidelines, nothing happens. Reroute, nothing happens. So it doesn't matter in which direction the normals are. Yeah, you will see the normals are changed now, because when I go near to the normals, you see now they go up, before they go down. I can show you this again, so I go to this, go to the stairway. You are now it's the correct way, regrow, and you see now they go down. But this is totally not what I want. The direction, I don't know why we don't have any minus Y here. So of course I can do something. I could make it now in the force or in the dynamic. Enable the dynamic, and the forces make a very high gravity, so that they go straight up, so they are down then. But sometimes, maybe here too, we can trick it. And it's more or less, I think, a bug or something else, I don't know. So, you cannot rotate the hair. When I go to the hair here, so let's go hair, rotate and rotate it to 90 degrees, that's not possible. Back. Then, maybe it's possible when I just rotate the axis. Axis, rotate, nothing happens. But now the funny thing comes when I go to the stairway. Because I can't rotate the stairway. But what I can do is, I can rotate the axis of the stairway. And now, look what happened. And this for sure should not be like this. So, let's go out of the axis tool. I even think when I go to the axis tool and bring it back now to null. No, that's not, but 180. Let's see, back. So now let's make the different length and everything. But it's sometimes when you change something, it goes with up again. Then you have to do this with the axis again. But it's at the beginning a little annoying. But later on we just convert it and that's it. The different sizes. We have here the hair material and the sizes you do over the hair material. I don't like the grid here. So, what do we have here? We have our hair here. Let's go to the hair, and let's say, please generate circles. We have now, you see, something like cylinders here. But they go to very, go down here, this is not what I want. And the thickness and everything you change in the hair material. The hair material is applied to the hair, you see. This happens automatically when you add hair. So I don't like specular, I don't want specular. And the hair color doesn't matter too, because you override this anyways. So let's say we want here 2 centimeter, 2 centimeter here, 2 centimeter here. Does not look bad. Okay. And the next thing is, I want not the length. I want to play with the scale here. The length is 100% is okay now, but the scale. You see what we get. Here is everything okay. Go out of this so we have to see it better. NA, so we see that we don't see the lines. And now we can play with the scale again. But we get this great effect here. And this is exactly what we're looking for. And here we have nicely, we totally don't overlap here, that's great. It's much worse in my original one. So, only thing I don't know why it is, because, I did change everything, huh? I thought I changed everything here, so but does not look like so. Okay, but I go to lower. Don't look at something. So see here we have a bug. This is the thing with the axis here. Let's see, when we go in the axis tool. Here we have some. And let's say we are happy with this. Maybe we should make this spaces smaller here. But this we can do late. No, we could do it now too, but let's hide. So you just click to this one here, the one you want to change. Come on, not in the axis tool. UW and T for scale. Just scale it up here. So you can change it, and normally the hair and everything should work, but now you see we are together here. So you can change this every time you want. Good, save it. And now what we can do is, so that we don't get problems with our hair, we can make our hair editable. So first we could play with the hair. So let's see, we can make hairs in the spline. No, I don't need it. Let's see, when I make splines, I can later on render with hair. No, that's not really not necessary. You can make this everything in the hair material here. We have scale thickness now. Let's say I want curl it. No, curl is so stupid. Let's say wave. But you won't see much because we have just in our hair, we have just one segment. So we have no points in between the guides. So it can't do something. It's just a stiff stick. Let's go to 8. And you see, we have this here, so let's go to 50. We get nice round things here. And of course, when we go to the stairway, R rotation, go to the axis mode, 180 degrees. Come on, so. And you get something like this, which looks nice too, I think. Let's see. Let's render this. It's a nice one too. But I make it now a straight thing. So I just want to show you this. So, disable the wave. And I throw this here in my backup folder. Maybe I want it later. So, disable it here. Go to here and just say, just hit C on the keyboard. That should be enough. And you see, our air is done. So what's here? What do we have? Some problems here, which are weird. That is weird. Let's go back. I want to see why this is. Come on. Oh, what a surprise, they're wrong. Stairway. 0, there's nothing. 180. Nothing, so they wanted. They wanted. Okay, rotate it. I really have no idea why they don't have a minus Y. But I don't want to complain, so. Here we have the same. Yeah, we have the same here. This must have a reason. What we can do, we can, let's make splines and make it with a sweep knob. I mean, we can play more then. So, go to generate, and don't generate, generate splines. So, and now if I make this editable, C on the keyboard, first, this is still in my backup folder, that's okay. C on the keyboard, boing. Okay, now we have the splines, and of course, if we have splines, we can make a sweep knob. 6 or 8 sides. Doesn't have to be a circle because from far we don't see if it's a circle or not. If we want a circle, just make a circle instead of the inside or give it more sides or something like this. So, sweep knob. Here under it. Now we still have some little things here. Let's see. This must have. Don't go to cubic, go to linear. Go to uniform. Go to 0. Come on, count. So, okay. We are happy, but no, not really. We are not really happy. They go to so. This is not what I want. Not better, not better. No. Let's copy this here up. So, rope. That is funny. It is shown down now. It is shown up here. Yeah. Somehow I can normally I can disable the guides, but guidelines. I don't want to see the guidelines, but to show the guidelines. Come on. Guides. This is the next one. Why is this not ordered in an alphabetical order? Can someone tell me this? Guides here. Oh, there's other guides, maybe. I think these are these guides here. From the guide tool, not from the hair tool. And let's see, maybe hair. Nope. That doesn't matter. But normally, here it stands guidelines, display guidelines, and I can't. This is funny. That doesn't matter. We know what to do, so stay away, edge mode. 180 degrees. Okay. Nice. So, okay, but now we are with the circle again. But we have these problems here. Maybe we can get rid of this when we go to the guides. And I have 50 seconds. Don't need a second because I don't want some curls or twists or kinks or whatever. Well, this is the annoying thing I told you. So, I'm not in the stairway here. Sometimes it works like this. Now it works. At least this works now. So, no, I made the whole staircase. Come on. I don't want to, I just want to make the axis. Okay. Good. We have here this, I like this. Here we could make this a little broader too, what I showed you before. And let's make it. We are in here. Now you see where they go. They go in a totally different direction. Maybe we should have done this with Cloner. So, UW, but I like to do it with hair because hair renders fast. This is one big advantage. UW. And one more. So nice. Good. Let's see how we get our hair in the correct direction. One. So this is what I want. Now we have here. This looks good too. Okay. And no, I don't want. I want. Don't want. Do we have? Oh, we don't have these troubles now anymore. This is nice. And why? Don't ask why. Oh, wait, one segment, this is okay. Ha, hit C. Okay. Yay, now we don't have this ugly phone breaks thing. Okay, we have it. So, now we have to do more, of course. No, we don't have to do more. Oh man, Sunday. Good. So let's hide here for the moment. Let's make this stair handle here. This is the reason why I didn't delete the spline for the cloner we needed it. No. So, and bring this here. Go out of the axis tool. So. Yeah, by the way, you don't have to go, and every time when you do this with the hair, you don't have to go in the axis tool normally. Just hold your L key on the keyboard and rotate it. It's the same. And make another one. So with control drag, I drag this to here. Same I do here. Drag this to here. And if you like one on the wall, here will come a wall. So, but I don't need it on the wall. So, oh, why not? Don't be lazy. So, okay. Nice. Then bring this whole thing up. This whole thing, not this one thing. Something like that. So handle. Okay, nice. Oh, but of course we have to extend our handle here. So let's do this. Go to a spline, wait, so, spline pen, first I deselect everything, oh, I select this one, here I want to extend my thing, so spline pen, and loop, and go to here, so that I don't do this now exactly how it should be, so, escape, so this looks of course like this. Bring it to here and bring it to here. So it should be. Now make this handle here and spline bend. Whoop. Somehow I like this thing. Tinkering. It's not bad. It's a funny work. Funny job. Okay. Good. Bring it down to here, so something like that. This one, spline band, whoop, chuck. Zip. Okay, you see we have a nice thing here. Now let's extend it here. First select the spline band, whoop, here. Something like that. I don't know if this is a good way I do it here, but I guess yes. Why not? You need to be a little patient, of course, but you have to be your whole life passion. So, what's that? No. Say no. And here, bridge it. Okay. And here we can bridge too. That's not bad. So this we can extend to here. Or can we? No, we can't. This is not what we want. So we have to make it. We have to make a new one. So we have to make it like these. Okay. That's a relaxing thing. Normally I have a beer or a wine next to me when I do things like this, but when I make a tutorial it's maybe not so good to have wine. When I make a tutorial it would be better to have whiskey or something. Good. And last one. Let's make it to here. Okay, now we should have a nice handle here. We have a nice handle. Don't forget to save, because this would be hard. Okay, and now we need some. Let's make a cylinder. Two maybe, and I make here 8 up height segments 1 and here 8. So, and this will be too long. Let's say 100. And we clone this along this stair spline, along this handle. Put this in a cloner. Boop, boop, boop. Cloner to object mode. Object is our stair spline. Wing. And please don't align our things. So that looks not so bad, I would say. Then go to transform and then Y transform. Bring it down a little bit. So we see this is a little bit there too big. So something like that should us. Too big still, so I bring it up a little bit again. Cloner. Okay, this will be a sweeper, the handle will be a sweeper, of course, too. And let's see how many we need. We want. I want at least a so. Let's see, it. We are not aligned here with correctly. That's because our spline is not aligned correctly. But we won't see this because of this whole hair things. We don't see this. So that does not really matter. So, what? Yeah, how many? I said count. But I know I want an even. Oh, a step. So this is step is good. Step is good. Step is good. I don't need so many. How does this look? And this is a little. A little komisch. A little weird. I want so. That's better. I want them so that they're almost in one row here. You see? And make it a little bit bigger. I think you see what I do, so I don't have to tell you, I think, here, because I do nothing special. I just play around with the values. So, okay, I think that's, this is that's enough. No, I'm gonna make it. What's when we take the half? Divide it by 2. Oh. Almost good. But this is. But as I said, we don't see this. So let's do. Let's play with this when we need it, if we need it. But we have everywhere nice. In the corner here, we have. Nice. Yeah? So here, this is okay. This is so far okay. Good. So save it. Don't forget to save. Now we make the same here with the ba-dum, 8, 2. Make a spline here and a sweepy. Whoops. And we have a wonderful handle here. Okay, save it. Bring back our hair. As you see nothing that they are under it, so this is. That would be unnecessary work to do this. So, R. So, Control R. Nice. We don't need you anymore here. We don't need you. R. So. Okay. Good. Now we need more. What do we need now? We need a wall, of course. We need doors, or something like doors. Let's see. Yeah, we are already almost done. So we need the doors, then these frames around the doors, and the wall with the pattern here, and yeah, and render it, and we are done. Good. Let's continue. How long? Oh, we have over 1 hour. Yeah, this is small things like. Playing with this here, go up, go up, go up, and bring it back. And this needs time. I am sorry, but it is so. The whole spine is a little too high for me. No, 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 no. I said the whole spline. We have a really nice setup here. We can change everything on the fly. And as I said, you don't see through here, so it doesn't matter if you have here the. Okay. Good. Save it. Next step. What can we do next? Let's bring in a. First, let's see a camera angle we need, or that we want, like something like that. Be sure that we have a camera angle that we have a parallel to the side here, so more than less. Yeah, this should be okay. If we don't have this, we can change it. We can correct this later on, until to a yeah, not totally, but if it's not too much. But if we have a little. Uncorrectness here, like this, you can correct this in Photoshop too. So there is in the camera raw filter that makes it automatically. So bring in a camera and protect deck and Yeah, this script I made this today because I eat it everywhere, every time that I go, the camera, the text, and search for the protection tag, where is it? So I make this into a big thing, and it is around next to the camera, and make a camera, and boom, protection tag. And if you want to do it, you will find it in the description, the script. So, don't need to see this. Whoops. Camera should be okay. And make a whoop plane. Did it here, so 90 degrees, T for scale, and scale it up like crazy. So nice. Of course, we have to bring it behind the stair. Okay. Do this is, yeah, to the render. I do not render, I think, in the octane, but then we have people there, octane. I start to render it. We don't have many, we have two materials or something as it is. So start to render it with the physical render and make then the two materials with the octane render too. So we don't need the hair material here. We would need it when we go back to our backup, but then we can make a new hair material, and that's it. Good. Save it, and I bring in my scene rig. This is the floor of the scene rig, but we don't need a floor here. Background and floor. Floor off. Bye bye. So, and GI. Let's see how it looks now. That looks much better. Okay, and we don't even have some materials on it, so the plane is too small. No, this is not too small. We have here. Here it stops. Okay. The next step is, yeah, let's make this doors, or let's make this pattern, or let's make the doors. Let's make the doors first. Save it again. Better to save twice as to forget it. The doors are quite easy to do. For this, I make a new file. Make a cylinder. 2, 8, boing. Okay, nice. Put it in the cloner. And I want in the x-axis, we have 3 cm in the x-axis, and I don't know how many. Let's see. Do they overlap? They overlap. Why do they overlap? 2 cm radius is okay. Oh, 2 cm radius is 4 cm, so we need 5 cm here. And this is how. Well, I think this is okay for my door. Maybe 20. So. And we have a space in between. This is I want it. Okay, we have the cloner. I bring this to the middle here. So. It's about the middle here, so it has not to be exactly, but so then we take a rectangle, boing, make it as big as this thing here, 200, and here, how many? There's 100. Maybe we have to go a little, oopsie. If you have this, you can't go back with this Control Z or Control C. You have to hit Control Shift C. This goes one step back for the camera. also for the camera position. So that's okay. Now we hide the clone for the moment. Go to rectangle, make it editable. C on the keyboard. Take these 2 points here. Whoops. Right click, chamfer, and as far as we can. Okay. We have a nice vzt. Okay. This vzt we will bring it in an extrude. Oops, extrude here. Alt click on extrude. Bring the cloner back. And the extrude has to go over the cloner, so E. Something like that, and we'll play here with pool. Normally I hate pool, but for this it's perfect. And we have our extrude. My extrude is default, should be a single object, that isn't, but doesn't matter. We can here to default, we have to go here to default. Then bring in a pool. And my pool by default is a high quality settings, create single object, yes. Hide new agent, yes, and to here, yes. So, and bring it in, and this one. And now the pool, I want just the intersections between the cylinders and the extrude. Intersect, point, and we have our door. Isn't this perfect? It has some here, it has nice caps too. No, not every, it has everywhere caps too. Nice, this is perfect. Okay, but it wouldn't be in the original. I had some with caps, some without caps, but that doesn't matter. So okay, we have our door. Take the pool, and I make this edit and optimize. If you don't have the script, just put everything in a connect object and hit C. Edit optimize. Okay. Door one, okay, copy, control C, go to the other project, control V, and we should have our door here inside. Okay, the door should go door one, make the door one here, door one is up and door two is downstairs. So here, a little bigger, T for scale. Maybe like this. This is totally on you how you want to make this. So that's, don't go too much with my thing. I love when you guys send me pictures and have your own ideas and everything. I really love this. But unfortunately, it happens not so often. Then often. So, same, make door two. So, save, bring it down here. Something like here. Okay, then take both of the doors. The doors, bring it on the wall, and we have wonderful doors here. Save it, and now then we need the frames around. And so I go back to my project here. Yeah, but good that I didn't close it, so I can go back here. Control C. Because I need this blind of the. I go back until I see the pool. So, yeah. I want this spline here. Copy this spline. As a door frame. Copy it, bring it back. Bring it into the scene. Here I have it. Bring door frame here under the door one and say reset PSR. Boing. Then I have it exactly behind it. So, and when I say now T, scale it until it's a little bigger here, so something like that. Control scale makes a copy and scales it. And again, control scale. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop, whoop. So nice. Good. I put them in a null object. Why not? Or put them all in under the door here. No. Bring it in a null object. Frame. Copy this frame under the door too. And see here, reset PSR, so we have the same here, and it is exactly the same position. This is funny. It looks like it was already sweeped, but we need a sweep out of this. So, but we need here, so go under the door. With shift click, I make a child of the, so I selected the door here, and with shift click, this spline or the object you put in will become a child of this. You see, this is exactly what we need, because we want to make a sweep again. Inside, select it, Alt, click sweep. Let's see if it works with the null object. I don't think so. Nope. But this isn't really a problem. I bring under the null object, I bring a connect object. Put this three in the connect object and go to the null object and here delete without children. You see, you can right click and delete without children. This is somewhere here. So now it deletes just the null object. And now with the connect object, the sweep works. Okay. Same I do here. I take this inside, put it in a sweep. Sweep. Got the frame. Shift click on connect, so it becomes child. This three under the connect, so the frame deleted. And chagang. Works. Save. We did it. Very nice here. Very nice, very nice, very nice. So now we need this funny pattern on the wall. Good. Let's see. So it's just 90 degrees. Good. Go to the plane here. And bring in the with N B. I see the lines. And let's see. I want some. But this is not bad. This size of the line. Maybe 30. 30 by 30. And now I make this plane simply editable. But I make a copy and hide it, or I make a copy in the backup folder. So. C to convert it, Z, and now simply go to here, go to the plane, go in edge mode, and UM is a path selection, and now you can like crazy make some funny paths here. Don't think a lot of it. So and something like here and out here. see how this looks. Maybe a little too boring. I can add something. So here we shift click, don't forget to shift when you want to add something. Maybe here something, and here something down here, so that it looks goes out. Okay. So we have a nice selection here, and what you do is simply go to the plane, edge to spline. This is, you will find this, if you don't have it in your toolbar already, you find it under mesh commands, I think, edge to spline. Whoop, this brings under our plane a new spline. Drag it out. This is the wall spline, let's see. Again, inside, eight sides, two. Bring it over there, so, and again a sweep. And we have this funny pattern on the wall. Okay, I think this is nice. Maybe I want the frames a little bigger, the doors. Tiefer scale, let's see if this works. I know what this one might be, okay. Then just these two, and then just this one. Okay, delete these three, copy these three under the connect object here. This should normally work, but of course, Alt G. And bring this, reset PSR, so. And delete the null again, and then we have it here. So, save it. And this is what these are like more. Did I do something here? No, this is the same. And again, I think this looks better than the original. So not the original, but my original. The original looks much better. You see here, we have a little problem. This is what I meant with to be parallel to the side. And now we see we stopped here, but this is no problem here. We can go to our wall spline. This is our wall sweep. Save it. So wall spline. Point mode, hit 0 for point selection and just drag this down. Look. Okay, save it and play a little with the camera. Let's see, bring the rotation deck to here, that doesn't matter for the moment. So. No, it looks good. Protection deck back. So, maybe that. Go and make the Y axis and go a little up with the Y axis. Yes. So, now save it again. End it. And I think that looks really nice. I love it. That's great. Let's play texturing. Good, we have something like we have the scene rig here, so I bring this up. We have a light inside, we don't need more. We need materials. So let's make a simple material, double click it. As I said always, I have here presets for materials, but the people want me to make it the materials from scratch, so why not? It's not so a problem. Let's bring this to let's bring my one material for all these sweeps. And for the cloner, yeah. Let's bring the material down here. This on the sweep, on the cloner. And this, yeah, we, I don't know if it need a different one, but for now, let's put it on the stairway. Of course, on the hair. But the hair, we, yeah, let's see. We know what it means. Stair here. Stair here. So, and camera, let's bring the camera up here. So, and the wall sweep, the plane not, but of course the doors. We don't need this selection text here. Can delete them. Door one, door two. The plane will be white. Everything different with it. Okay, so we have this. These are the sweeps and whatever. And make another one. And these are the wall. The wall is a simple diffuse material. No, a little reflectance we give it. Here I take a Pac-Man. Roughness. Okay, and here what I have here, dielectric. It's asphalt. Okay, this is the wall, plane, wall. Well. save it. Maybe bring our wall sweep a little in the front. The axis is here, but it doesn't matter. So not more than the, so let's see. Yeah, that's better. Okay. And the sweeps, let's see what we do here. And here a Pac-Man too. This is enough for this dielectric, of course. I will take something. Doesn't really matter here. Let's see. Something like jade, maybe. The color. I did the other end. I did with octane. So I mean, I took something like a specular material, so like a very rough glass material. But this would need too long to render here, of course. In octane, it doesn't matter. Quality a little higher. So okay, but that's not so bad. Let's play with it. Maybe let's make it a subdivision, a subsurface scattering. Maybe could look nice. This. And multiple fast evaluation. And let's see what we can do here. Ketchup, chicken, cream. Ah, that looks not bad. If as smaller this number is, as longer it needs to render it. So be a little careful, but you see it looks nice here. We have here a little darker, and if it goes down, it gets another color. That's not bad. That's definitely not bad. That's marble. Show us something, please. Was it this? No, huh? Vagina is slow today, I don't know why. Normally it is much faster, my thing. Notice this I don't like. Potato. Chicken. So looks chicken. I'm not really sure if this is chicken. Old chicken. So. Now come on. No apple. You can take it, color whatever you want. But the brighter color here is definitely better. No, not really, but this looks like this looks nice, like waxy for this I like. Let's make something with this. First I go a little up with the path length, so we don't have to wait so long for the render. And let's see. I don't know. Okay. Let's see what we get here. Let's go down with the quality here a little bit. I have to see. That looks not bad. But I think I will do it without a subsurface scattering, at least not now, because I want to make some. First, I want to make some light tries. And don't think I really need subsurface scattering. Let's make something like wood or something else. Now I bring in the texture a little noise. And multiply it, of course. Make it a little bigger, so let's say 300, and stretch the y-axis 400, even more, 700. See, we get a little, no, that looks nice, and then we get a little weathering effect. Okay. But it is a little too dark for me, so let's go with the brightness. that looks not bad, maybe. Yes, I like this. And now I try to bring a nice HDRI or something else inside. So let's make it a little more space. Okay. Go to my scene rig. HDRI settings. Let's see if we can make here. Let's bring the preview on, and the preview is very small here, so it's like bigger. The link for the scene rig you will find in the description too, if you want to buy it, and you can download the light version too. But then of course, the light version is a light version; it's not really. You don't have as much possibilities with it. That is not bad, but let's try different HDRIs. Shift F8 to come in the content browser, Wink, and I would say we test some outdoor maps here. Okay, maybe not the correct one, so we have enough here. You will find enough free HDRIs on the internet. Just Google it. There are so many free ones. HDRI Heaven is one of my favorites, and I recommend go to HDRI Heaven and support them on Patreon, and you will get very nice things. And when we speak about it, you can support me on Patreon too. You will find a link in the description. And if you want to support me, please do so. Don't hesitate. Do it. Don't think twice. It's all right. Yay, now we have a nice one. This is a nice one for me. Okay, I think I will make a nice render with it for a higher resolution, but now this is, yeah, that looks great. We have nice things, nice weathering effect here. We have nice glossiness on this, on the stair here, on the stairway. Yeah, I think we have it. Maybe let's play a little bit with the noise here. And because we don't have a seat, not speed seat. The seat is not in. It's not possible in the, because I don't want it so hard here on the doors. So now let's try it with 2D maybe. So I think I have to make this smaller or bigger? I think bigger. Let's stay with texture. Maybe test another. And here we can play with the seed. the seed just distributes the noise differently. Everyone, when you click on the seed, it makes a new coincidentally position change thing. Somehow it is not stretched enough. 1000. I'm sure this could look nice with wood too, but now I think I have what I want. I can make it more contrasty here, so like this. There are the possibilities are endless. Here I like it on the door, the black light things. This is what I like. Okay. Yeah, and we are done, I would say. Same like here. Let's hide here the preview and make it again, so. Okay. I'm happy with it. For the tutorial, I think it's very nice thing. Maybe it make the handle a little thicker. So these, I think the handles, yeah. Handle. Chrono. Handle. Okay. And I think I make this sweep a little thicker. Yeah, that looks better because it looks more stable. Yeah, that's now nice. This is definitely better. And make the cylinder maybe one more. That is definitely better. Okay. We are done. I hope you liked this. And yeah, if you want to see how I make this bird house here, you see we are 100 minutes. And if you want to see it, but I tell you how I did it. I made a cube and rotated it 45 degrees. And just took this to. Do I have to? Maybe I have to. Let's see if. Maybe I have the project file still. No, I think I deleted it. No, unfortunately, I deleted it. It doesn't matter. Yeah, and I cloned cylinders on it here on the surface. I took these points here up and cloned from there. And yeah, oh, should I show you this? This is at least another hour. No. You know what, people? Tell me if you want to see this one too. And I told you that this is just a cube I'm doing, and then I selected the same. I selected on the cube on the plane. I selected the cube the points here, and here I selected just from here to here, and in the middle I made another selection just for the shorter ones. And yeah, and on the sides, I made here a selection too for the side things and everything. So it's almost the same, just with the cloner. Cloner in the point selection, cloner on vertex mode, and this different length you get with the random deformer, of course, with the random effect, of course. Yeah, that's more than less it. But it is a little work to set it up. So, and I made this. I don't know why I deleted it. I made a whole rig and with Express and everything, and then I deleted it. I'm really not. I'm not the cleverest guy, believe me. No, I don't have it here. Just have the picture. That doesn't matter. Okay, if you wanna see it, I will make another tutorial for this one. Okay, I hope you liked this, and as I said, I make now a better render for the preview, for the tutorial preview. And yeah, I will make next week. I have a little more time. I see that I can do something. I have some really interesting questions. I got some really interesting questions, but for most of them, I have to prepare a little bit, and most of them I have to try it in front before, but because they are some are really complicated, and I can do it. I can do it live, but it's too complicated, and I think I tried every time to find a much easier way, and when I try and try and try and think and think and think, I every time I find a better way. So. And here I see it's much too glossy. Yeah. That's good. Okay. Let's make a middle render. So go to middle GI. Let's see how fast this render, if it renders fast. Ah, it renders crazy fast. Okay, let's try a high render. It's not so fast. Yeah, of course it's not so fast. This is high. But here we can play, of course, with the filter. Oh, here I have some settings, and maybe a little back with the exposure here. Back is the other direction. Okay, don't need it. Don't need a filter here, it looks. Huh? Yeah, maybe. Little contrast does not, it's not wrong. Okay. So, history is there. Right. Oh, I'm not 100% here. That is the reason it looks so shaky. Now it looks much better. Okay, we have here our result. Okay, hope you liked it, as I said. And if you have requests, if you have questions, please ask me in the comments or on Facebook. I would love it, or I would be happy if you subscribe to my Facebook group, and of course to my Facebook site too. But in the Facebook group, you can ask your questions, you can post your results, you have a nice community there, and they are all really willing to help and everything, and they are clever guys, and yeah. So read the description. You find everything you need, you find in the description, and especially you find the link for donation. And if you wanna support me on Patreon, you can do so, and you will find the link there too. And if you are a patron from 5 € and above, you will get every project file here. I'm making the tutorials, and you will get in between project files, and like last time, the texture packs and everything. So I have some gifts, and Yeah, and if you are a Patreon over 10 euro, you can download the Nikomedia Scene Rig, the pro version. The ultimate version you can buy as well. Just please read the description. Everything you need, you will find there. Yeah. Okay. So I wish you a wonderful Sunday, and hope to see you in the next. Or hope you are with me in the next video. And yeah, tell me if you want to see it with webcam and so things. As I said, I wouldn't know why, but I'm not so beautiful, I think. And yeah, I'm a little heavy and I think I don't fit on a 1080p monitor. I'm not sure. Okay, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, I wish you all the best and the best regards from here, from Vienna in Austria, and see you soon. And so now my last words, as you know, tschüss und baba.